Hello guys, today I'm going to try to explain why I sample my basslines in most cases. But first a short disclaimer. Despite the name of the tutorial, you don't need to sample your basslines. It's all up to you what you find best for your workflow. There are thousands of ways of making a good kick and bassline. Today I'm just going to show you my process and the reasoning behind why I sample my basslines. I have three main reasons why I usually sample my basslines. The first one is individual note compression, which I will explain later on in the video. The second reason is dealing with the problem of the last note of the bassline overlapping the transient of the kick. And for number three, I have saving CPU while still having an option to change the MIDI pattern. First, I'm going to play you the sampled bassline. As you can see, both the kick and the bassline are playing almost at 0 dB. As a personal preference, I like using individual note compression rather than putting a compressor over the whole sequence. I find it easier to dial in the amount of compression needed. I'm now going to play the whole sequence with the same compressor settings. You can hear that it's catching the first note of the bassline and emphasizing it too much. Here you can see it also. And you can see that the decay of the last bassline is overlapping the kick. I will now play you the same bassline without the compression. I will bounce it down to an audio channel. And I will place it in the kick and bass group. If you remember from the start of the tutorial, the first kick and bass line didn't go over 0 dB, but this one, although it's 2 dB lower, it's clipping the group channel by 2 dB. This is all because of the decay on the last note to the bass line, which overlaps the kick transient. This is an easy fix. You don't need to sample each note individually. You can just sample the whole sequence and just cut out the overlapping part. I will also make a small fade out on the last note. As you can see now, the problem is fixed, and as a result, we can turn up our bassline even louder and it won't go over 0 dB. Now we'll show you how I go about sampling each note. I will bounce the bass line to an empty audio channel. Now I will cut out only 1/16th of the note, removing the garbage around it. This will ensure that no bass notes are overlapping the kick. I will adjust the fade in and fade out. I will just drag the note into an empty drum rack. And now I can draw in some MIDI notes. I did the same process for a couple of different notes, and now I can change the MIDI sequences on the fly whenever I want without unfreezing and refreezing the VST again.